Dr. Takashi Kamei.
How we can implement thorium molten salt reactor. Before this March, I thought what I should talk at this conference. But you know, we had a very big, huge earthquake. I decided to change my title of the presentation, Japan Revival Strategy by Thorium Molten Salt Reactors. Before starting my talk, I'd like to say thank you to all US people and of course to the world people. There are many help. We are, very damaged. And still there are many people under the very heavy situation. But myself, I'm not injured anyway, because I'm living in 700 kilometers far from the Fukushima and earthquake site. But anyway, I'd like to thank you to all. I'm carrying my own study and research at the university in Kyoto, focusing on the sustainability, the global warming, or the climate change. And this is still a very big challenge, not for Japan, but not only for Japan, but also for the world. 40% of the carbon dioxide coming from the power generation in the world. But the second point is the transportation sector. Nearly the 20% of the carbon dioxide in the world coming from the automobiles, of course the gasoline cars or the diesel cars. In order to reduce emitting of the carbon dioxide from the world or the activity of the human beings, we have to think about both the power generation and transportation. China is the largest carbon dioxide emitting countries. They are now emitting about 21% of the carbon dioxide in the world. And the second is the US, nearly the 20%. And Japan also emitted a large amount of the carbon dioxide, but the percentage is maybe the 4.5% in the world. And so this is a big challenge for the world, for us. Is there a solution? I think yes. We need a clean energy which does not emit carbon dioxide. But of course, it must be a safe one. We had a huge earthquake and the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant explodes because of the damage of the earthquake. So we have to find such a way. The answer will be the thorium molten salt reactor. A thorium molten salt reactor contains two keywords. One of them is, of course, thorium. Just before my talk, Dr. Rubron made a very good lecture in order to know what is good with the thorium. But roughly speaking, the thorium itself has these advantages. So it does not emit carbon dioxide when it produces electricity, and it can be obtained from the mining of the rare earth materials. Its amount is very huge in the world. Unfortunately, Japan do not have a lot of thorium. This is a nuclear fuel, so it produces a radioactive waste, but the amount is very, very small compared to the uranium usage. And there will be a lot of discussions, but thorium use utilization is not so good for the nuclear weapons. These are the advantages of the thorium utilization. The reason why I talk about the thorium. Thorium can be used, of course, in light water reactors. And the US private company Lightbridge, is there anybody coming from Lightbridge? No? Okay, anyway, I love light water reactors, even though we had a big accident in Japan. Because light water reactor is an established technology, and nearly the 400 nuclear power plants based on the light water reactor is now operating in the world and produce the electricity to the world. And the thorium can be used as a fuel load. Many Japanese people concerned and worried about the using a light water reactor in the world because they think that there will be an earthquake also in the world. But if you look at this picture, the black dot, small dot, indicates the point of the huge earthquake. If you look at the blue circles in this map, there are many places where do not have any earthquake. For example, in the Middle East, like Saudi Arabia, we cannot find any dot of the earthquake. In the northern part of the Africa, we don't have any earthquake. And here in the US, we are now in Washington. The most part of the U.S. do not have the huge earthquake. Of course, in California, there are many earthquakes, so we have to take care of this. And in Europe, not many earthquakes. But Japan, can you find Japan in this map? Japan is covered with a lot of earthquakes. And once the earthquake hits the nuclear power plant, it is possible to come to a big accident. But I'd like to inform you about one thing. Today, we are facing the accident at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. But the nearest power plant to this earthquake was the Onagawa nuclear power plant. This is a different electricity company in Japan. But the Onagawa nuclear power plant, of course, it was shut down when the earthquake hit the nuclear power plant. And the core emergency cooling is safely operated. And now more than 300 people are escaping the additional attack of the earthquake. And they are now living at this Onagawa nuclear power plant site. So I like to say that if the light water reactor is correctly operated, it is still safe even in the case of the earthquake. I also like to say that Japan should think about the use of the thorium molten salt reactors. This is a rough sketch of a thorium molten salt reactor will act when it is hit by the earthquake. Maybe the cooling of the core will be stopped. The temperature will increase, but the freeze valve will open, and automatically the fuel will drain to the lower tank. And we don't need any external voltage in order to drive these actions. So this is very safe. And what we have to think about the influence of the radioactive material to the human beings. Of course, the alpha ray and the beta ray and the, of course, gamma ray will influence human body. But it comes from the radioactive materials. Yes, it will possible that the tank will break, will be broken, and the fuel salt will come out. But in a room temperature, it becomes solid or freezed. And most of the radioactive materials will be kept inside of this frozen fuel salt. And that means the radioactive materials will be kept inside this frozen salt. Yes, it is true. Radio gamma ray, something like that, will be emitted to the outside, but the range will be limited to be few hundred meters, not kilometers, few hundred meters. So it will be able to people don't come near to this site. After the accident of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant, what Japan can do? The left-hand side is a map of Japan, and the red big circle indicates the nuclear power plant. We have several nuclear power plants which have a huge electricity capacity. For example, the Tokyo Electric Company owns a nuclear power plant in Fukushima. It is about 700 gigawatts. And once this site is attacked by the huge earthquake, all of this power generation is stopped once. So if we construct the future design of the electric supply in Japan, right-hand side will be the new concept. The small, safe power reactor will be scattered in the whole land of Japan. It will be possible that one of them will be hit and stopped by earthquake, but it will be limited to lose merely 100 megawatts. If we implement the small size nuclear power plant, something like the thorium molten salt reactor, its economy must fit to the available one. If the reactor becomes a small size, we don't need to use the seawater to cool the reactor core. Thorium molten salt reactor becomes small, maybe we can use air to cool the reactor core. I have been talked about the advantage of the thorium itself and the molten salt reactor. But then we have to think how we can achieve the implementation of the thorium. At the moment, the technology to utilize the thorium is established in a light water reactor or a heavy water reactor in Canada, it will be possible to start use thorium in these reactors. But maybe in the middle term, maybe the 10 years from now or 15 years, a molten salt reactor will be the very good candidate. Much longer time, maybe the accelerator-driven system or some other will be available. But in any case, we have to think that the thorium does not contain a fissile isotope. So in order to fire the thorium molten salt reactor or other reactors, we have to prepare not only the thorium but also the fissile. Right now, we are using the uranium for the fuel in the light water reactor or the heavy water reactor like CANDU. Once we put the uranium in these reactors, we can produce plutonium. The yellow circle indicates the production of the plutonium. At the moment in Japan, in case Japan is going to use the plutonium in a first breeder reactors, but we can modify our policy of energies. If this plutonium can fed to the thorium reactors like light water reactors or the thorium heavy water reactors, it will be possible. And of course, there will be an opportunity that this plutonium directly fed to the thorium molten salt reactors. And once the thorium light water reactor or heavy water reactor or molten salt reactor is operated, uranium-233 comes out. And this can be fed as a fissile isotopes for thorium utilization for the next generation. Roughly speaking, the supply of plutonium coming from the uranium cycle, supply of the uranium-233 is still very limited. So maybe in a long future, some direct production of the uranium-233 from thorium will be needed. In the beginning of my talk, I talked about global warming, and the transportation sector is very important. In Japan, Toyota or Nissan or Honda, they are now going to supply the hybrid cars or electric vehicles. And in order to fabricate these vehicles, which is different from the gasoline car or the diesel cars, the key element is, of course, rare earths. For example, the neodymium or the dysprosium are used for the make a permanent magnetic, which is used for the electric motors. The 97% of the rare earths is produced from China. It is not so apparently said to the world, but at the same time of the thorium mining processing, thorium is occurred. So if Japan wants to leave the chain of the China in a supply of the rare earths, Japan have to go to the other countries like Vietnam or India, of course sometimes Brazil. But the problem is the thorium, because the thorium is a radioactive material, and if we don't take care about the thorium, it becomes the environmental hazard, or sometimes the people living around this place will be healthy injured. But if the thorium is used as nuclear fuel, this problem will be solved. Once the thorium is fed to the thorium reactors, and sometimes plutonium will be fed to the reactor, of course, at the same time, it produces electricity, and this electricity will be fed to plug-in hybrid or electric vehicle. So the thorium is not a problem, but the solution, especially for Japan, and maybe I think for US too. How much can we implement the thorium molten salt reactor? This is a global scale, not only the Japanese case. This design of the molten salt reactor is a thermal and graphite usage. And so calculation will be different if we apply the fast reactor or much other design. And the black dot line indicates electricity capacity of the uranium light water reactor. We are now using nearly the 370 gigawatt in the world. For each increase based on the prediction by the IEA, the curve will be like this. And based on this implementation capacity of the uranium usage, the spent nuclear fuel will be produced. It indicates the red line. So it is very easy to see that if spent nuclear fuel coming from the uranium usage is not used, it exceeds to very large amount. But once this is used for the thorium molten salt reactor, the amount of the spent nuclear fuel will decrease very rapidly. But the implemented capacity of the thorium molten salt reactor based on only the supply of the plutonium coming from the uranium uses is very limited, even though we utilize the uranium-233 coming from the plutonium sodium molten salt reactor, is still limited. The total capacity will be 300 gigawatts around 2050. It is still very small. If uranium light water reactor do not expand its capacity in the next 40 years, capacity of the sodium molten salt reactor will be about 258 gigawatts at 2050. This is still very small. Yesterday, when we visited the Congress people, John told us that we don't make an enemy. Okay, and so I like to say that the sodium utilization is very important, but uranium usage is still important. If we think about the global warming or the global scale, this is my document which I wrote in a popular newspaper in Japan. This is English version. Look at your website, you can find still the sodium utilization will be still limited, even though it is used in the global scale. It means that the sodium production is very huge in the world, but the consumption of sodium is still limited. It means there will be a stockpile of the sodium. If this sodium is not used, it comes to the environmental hazard. This is just a concept, and maybe I will be able to talk in detail about this concept in the next conference. In Japan, I wrote this kind of book. This is, I'm sorry, only in Japanese, but I wish that I can be able to publish some English version in the near future. Thank you for the opportunity to talk here. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you so much.